the 11th of April, New Delhi. There we have one auditorium by name Mavlankar Auditorium. Mavlankar Auditorium has a seating capacity for about 3,000, as I estimate. A beautiful auditorium, like our college auditorium. Yes, something like that, compact. Nice chairs, cushion chairs, as in a gallery. Here the stage. Swami sat there on the dais. In Mavlankar Auditorium, a colloquium or a symposium is organized that evening at 5:30 on 11th of April. On either side of the dais, we have huge posters of Swami's pictures, which are very, very imposing. People started watching all the pictures and teachings of Swami, which were kept hanging around the auditorium. Swami sat there on the dais. The symposium on the topic, Sai Way for Human Development, Sai Way for Human Progress, that was the topic. And then the entire gathering was welcomed by the air marshal in those days, air chief by name Suri. Suri welcomed the entire gathering in a most befitting way. He welcomed Swami to Delhi after 11 years. He welcomed the vast gathering. He welcomed in a befitting way, in a most appropriate way, the speakers of the day. The speakers of the day included three. The first speaker is Sunil Mittal of Airtel. You know Airtel, cell phones, communication is one of the a profit-making industry. This Mittal is the head of that Airtel management. Very rich man, a top industrialist, first speaker. Suri said, Mittal started his business in a very humble way with 25,000 capital. And today he manages 25,000 crores of capital. How he has grown in stature in the field of industry. The second speaker is our former Vice Chancellor of Sri Sathya Sai University, Sri S.V. Giri. And the third speaker is the former Vice Chancellor of Sri Sathya Sai University, Professor G. Venkatraman. Well, that was the program of the day. But what I am interested is this. It was Mittal who said, frankly, openly, Bhagavan, I am not a devotee. But my wife, my brothers-in-law, my parents-in-law are your devotees. They visit you, they worship you. And my children who are receiving higher education abroad are blessed by you long ago. The whole family is doing fine because of your blessings. And then he said, Swami, I am inspired by your message. I am inspired by your illustrious example. I started 350 schools in which 5,000 children receive their education, and mostly are girls. With your blessings, Bhagavan, I would like to extend this education facilities to 1 lakh students in the near future. I pray for your blessings. That's what Mittal said. When he said these words, it touched my heart, I tell you. As a matter of fact, everybody must have been literally moved by his wonderful statement. Well, he was followed by S.V. Giri, who explained the education program of Bhagavan, including Grama Seva. He also made a mention of water project, and he also made a mention of the medical services extended here in Prachanthanalayam. His talk was followed by G. Venkatraman, the former Vice Chancellor of Sri Satya University and the Director of Sai Radio for Global Harmony and Sri Satya Digital Studio functioning there in Prachanthanalayam. G. Venkatraman, what he did was, he made use of audio-visual aids with all PowerPoint presentation on two huge screens. He explained all the details of the water project undertaken by Bhagwan Baba. What was Anantapur district before? What is Anantapur district today? How people were before the water project, suffering from the shortage or the dearth of water, walking miles and miles to fetch pot full of water. He has shown those slides. And today, how the tanks are built, how pipes are laid, all pictures, films are showed there. And today, how people are happy, and some of the beneficiaries are interviewed. The audio-visual presentation by Venkatraman is certainly impressive. That's the program for the day. And then, there on that day, following the symposium, in the same Avalankar auditorium, old boys, meaning former students of Sri Satya University, staged a drama, and also youth from Delhi, Sevadal, participated in the drama. They acted very well. The theme is this: a man leading a simple life, a happy life, married, suddenly confronts a problem. His mother-in-law comes and says, why don't you go abroad? Why don't you earn more money? With that, the whole problem starts. The young girl is very much disturbed, influenced by the words of the mother. Go on goading the husband to earn more, get more gold, go abroad. Like these things, she went on pestering her husband. The boy is almost restless, without peace. But in the turn of events, that old lady understands that all this gold currency are useless when the time comes. Then they realize the values and the spiritual life. That's how the family finally settles down as a happy home, totally contented with whatever they have. The drama has got a good message. There are one or two dances also, and Swami really enjoyed the jokes and the humor in the drama, made Swami laugh. We are very, very happy about it.